The significant role of Lincolnshire pioneers such as Joseph Banks, Matthew Flinders, John Smith, and George Bass has shaped vast areas of the world. In addition, ready to celebrate his birth, the historic bustling market town of Spilsby is home to one more notable explorer. Sir John Franklin. In an attic above his father's shop, Franklin was born in the town centre in 1786, and from the age of 12 he would seek a life of seafaring that would take him on several expeditions around the world. Related to Matthew Flinders, he would join his older cousin as midshipman on important voyages around Australia. He was present in the Battle of Trafalgar and would later become Lieutenant Governor of Tasmania. But most importantly, he would be remembered for his Arctic voyages to map through northern Canada and the Northwest Passage. In 1821, he was the first to map large areas of the Arctic seaboard, an incredibly difficult expedition that would ultimately lead to him being given the nickname the Man Who Ate His Boots. This was due to the fact that when confronted by starvation, his instincts led him and his men to eat lichen and parts of his leather boots in order to survive. With his vast wealth of knowledge and experience, Franklin was chosen to lead the challenge, and his two ships set sail in 1845. Lady Jane Franklin never gave up hope, and by means of sponsorship and rewards, she raised funds to instigate many searches for her husband. His final voyage would end in tragedy when he died in 1847, but his legacy shows an immense contribution to the route as we know it today. It would in fact be the subsequent searches to find Franklin that eventually completed the last part of the route. In recognition of his achievements in exploration, various countries have dedicated many sites to his name. In Britain, he is fondly remembered and with high esteem. And not to mention in his hometown. The town is surrounded by significance. Close by are the ruins of Bolingbroke Castle, the birthplace of Henry IV. And only 4 miles away is the stately home of Gumby Hall. Nearby Somersby just happens to be the birthplace of the poet Alfred Lord Tennyson. The impact on the world of Spilsby's most famous son has certainly been profound.